After almost every film fan has seen Marvel's Avengers Endgame in the cinema and the hype doesn't seem to fade away, it's worth taking a look at the upcoming films that will be released in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. With a multi-billion dollar company like Disney, the timetable for the upcoming blockbusters is of course quite strictly scheduled. The post-Avengers section, also called Phase 4, has still a lot to offer. However, if you haven't seen Avengers Endgame yet, you should catch up as soon as possible, as in the following video there is an increased danger of spoilers. On the one hand, there is the upcoming Spider-Man Far From Home, which will be the last movie in Phase 3. In the trailer, you see the young superhero sitting on a building, followed by a fight scene and Spider-Man getting asked by one of the policemen if he would become the new Iron Man, after his idol Tony Stark had to die in Endgame. But that doesn't seem to be the case at first, since Spider-Man has other plans that will take him all the way to Europe. There he will have a lot to do, as the big cities of Europe don't seem to be safe from anything. The trailer also leaves some questions unanswered, because many fans ask themselves which role Mysterio will play, and whether he wants to help Spider-Man or harm him in the end. On the 2nd of July we will find out more, as then Spider-Man Far From Home will be shown in cinemas and will end MCU Phase 3. After a short break, Phase 4 will continue in 2020. This will most likely be initiated at the beginning of May with Black Widow. On Vormir, she sacrificed herself for Red Skull to get through the Soul Stone. This means that Black Widow won't be part of future Avengers adventures, but she still has the honor to start Phase 4 with her own solo movie. The film is currently in pre-production and is scheduled to be shot in June 2019 under the direction of Kate Shortland. In terms of content, the film about Natasha Romanoff is set in the past, so it's a prequel. The film will probably even play before her MCU debut in Iron Man 2. The storyline will mainly revolve around the life story of the KGB agent, who has her origins in the USSR. In order to escape her death, she emigrates to New York City before the collapse of the Soviet Union, and is then transferred to another secret organization, the well-known SHIELD. Scarlett Johansson will therefore also play the leading role in the Black Widow solo film. Besides her, Rachel Weisz, Florence Pugh and David Harbour will complete the cast. Black Widow will probably be released in the cinemas in May 2020. There is still relatively little known about the film The Eternals that will probably follow. Marvel boss Kevin Feige recently announced that The Eternals will be an overwhelming one. And this is also clearly shown by the planned commitments of some Hollywood stars, among them Angelina Jolie as Cersei and according to Variety, Game of Thrones star Richard Madden as Icarus. Madden is of course known to many as Robb Stark, but he also played the role of Prince Charming in Disney's new live-action Cinderella movie. So it's a good fit that they want to make him the intergalactic hero Icarus. However, what's already certain besides the speculations about the cast is that The Eternals will have an unbelievably storyline of tens of thousands of years, which is a pretty ambitious project. For the production, the writer-director Chloe Zhao has been acquired. The Eternals will probably be released as the second MCU film next year on November 6, 2020. We speculate that The Eternals will be followed by Black Panther 2. After the first part mutated to a box office hit, especially in the US and even won 3 Oscars, it's not surprising that they will put everything into an equally successful second part. Attention, spoiler danger for all which have not seen the first part yet. In the sequel, all actors of the first part will be part of it, among them Michael B. Jordan as the villain Killmonger. He was actually killed, yet they will find a way to assign him a leading role by using flashbacks or dream sequences. Sterling K. Brown, who portrays Killmonger's father, promises the fans an incredibly good sequel. Black Panther has definitely built up a good fanbase and will probably be released in 2021. Speaking of a decent fanbase, another film from the MCU, Doctor Strange, also has one. After the first part from 2016, it has stayed quiet around news to the successor, and this despite the big appearances in Avengers Infinity War and Endgame. By the way, we also point out the danger of spoilers if you haven't seen the first part yet. Since a couple of days there are news that Twitter user Roger Waddell didn't want to withhold from us. Of course, this information is to be enjoyed with caution, but nevertheless some information about Endgame was made public here in the past, which turned out to be true afterwards. If you believe the mysterious Twitter user, the Ancient One who died in the first part will return in the second part. Furthermore, 2 new characters will be established. One is the twin brother of Daniel Drum, also called Brother Voodoo. The other one is Clea Strange from the Dark Dimension who will play a role in the second part. The one who didn't get mentioned in the tweets is Mordo, who is named in the post-credits of Doctor Strange. He should have become the new antagonist since he wants to steal the wizard's powers. In our opinion, a return as an antagonist is quite likely in the second part, as he is one of the greatest opponents of Benedict Cumberbatch alias Doctor Strange in the comics. Also, here we expect a release date in 2021. The Guardians of the Galaxy series has always worked very well separately from the other Marvel movies. Director and scriptwriter James Gunn announced after the first part of Guardians that he wanted to create his own little trilogy in the MCU. 2 years have passed since the second part, and in the meantime the two Marvel blockbusters Avengers Infinity War and Endgame, in which the Guardians also played an important role, were running. Especially after the epic Endgame, many fans are now even more excited for the third part of the Guardians. Gunn announced that they would like to take a closer look at the role of Rocket Raccoon and its creation. In addition, there is the rumor that he will apparently start a romantic relationship with the Archer Lady Lila. Gunn did not confirm this rumor, but promised a more stirring story about the Raccoon Man than in his predecessors. So, the story is a bit more personal than its previous ones. The many questions of fans regarding Thor, Gamora and Drax are difficult to answer as long as the density of information is as low as it is current. Guardians of the Galaxy 3 is expected to be released in 2022, unless the shooting starts earlier than planned. Hopefully, we could give you a small overview on the future of the MCU. The order of the mentioned Phase 4 movies is of course not yet completely set, but according to our sources it is quite likely. Of course, we'll also keep you up to date as usual with our news episodes every Sunday, including the Marvel films.